Not even the marching of mighty armies can hold us.
Yes, sir.
We are moving to the land of freedom.
Greetings. On behalf of the North San Diego County NAACP, I'm excited for you all to be joining us here today as we celebrate the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. I would especially like to extend a heartfelt thank you to Ms. June Parks and the other champions of the NAACP who, without their vision 32 years ago, we would not be standing before you today. Racial disparities have long pervaded throughout the fabric of this country, and today, as we reflect on the journey of selfless service, let us not forget the efforts in which the catalyst of activism made dreams into possibilities. In the words of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., even the most misguided among us can learn to respect
the dignity and the worth of all human personality.
Well, praise God, and we thank the Lord for this opportunity to once again enjoy and fellowship with the NAACP for the annual Dr. Martin Luther King Prayer Breakfast. And so what a wonderful privilege it is for me as pastor of Shiloh Church of God in Christ in Oceanside, California. My name is Pastor George Bailey, and it's a privilege and a pleasure to be able to do the opening prayer for this event. This is a wonderful occasion that we're marking here in remembrance and also in obedience and observance to everything that Dr. King has done throughout his lifetime for us to be able to follow. And so, if you will, I invite you to pray with me now as we call upon the Lord to help us not only to remember, but also to continue to walk out what Dr. King has exemplified for us. Let's pray. Almighty God, we thank you for your wonderful love and grace and your mercy. God, in these troubling times that we are living in today, Lord God, where this evil and ugly head of racism and prejudice and inequality is rearing its head once again in a vicious manner, God, we pray in the name of Jesus, that you, Lord God, help us not only to remember what Dr. King has done, the life that he's shown us, Lord God, of how we are to love one another. God, help us, O Lord God, to walk out these things in our lives. Dr. King exemplified, Lord God, how he followed you, and in every way he showed his obedience to your word and your will. So God, help us, Lord God, truly according to your word, to follow him as he followed Christ. And God, we endeavor to be people of mercy, people of love, people that show the true spirit of Jesus living in and through us. God, we thank you, Lord God, for the privilege of being your children, your servants. And so God, help us to be the servants that you want us to be. God, as we take up our cross and we take up the mantle, Lord God, of servants and lights in this world, help us, Lord God, to bring glory and praise to your name. Just as Dr. King has exemplified for us, help us to glorify you and magnify you, O Lord God, and change the world around us. God, we thank you for such a blessing and privilege for living out and being doers of your word. God, we honor you today, and we thank you, Lord God, for all that you're doing in and through us. We give you praise and glory even now. In Jesus' name, amen.
I don't think the important thing is how long one lives. I think it's how well one lives. Not the quantity of one's life, but the quality of one's life.
Founded in 1909, in response to the ongoing violence against black people around the country, the NAACP, National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, the largest and the most preeminent civil rights organization in the nation. We have well over 2,200 branches and units around the nation and well over 2 million activists. Our mission is to secure the political, educational, the social, and the economic equality of rights to eliminate race-based discrimination and ensure the health and well-being of all people.
we are involved in a movement which causes us to sing over and over again that we are not afraid.
Hi, everybody. This is Congressman Mike Levin, proud representative for North County, San Diego, and South Orange County. Every year, we come together as a nation to celebrate the life and legacy of civil rights hero, Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. A fearless leader and powerful orator, Dr. King paved the long, treacherous road toward equality for all Americans. Over the last year, we've experienced an important racial reckoning with momentous marches, demands for justice, and historic elections. Most recently, unfortunately, we experienced an attack on our nation's capital and our democracy itself, unlike anything we've seen in modern American history. But in the end, our democracy prevailed, and there will be justice. So as we enter a new age for our country, let us not forget, darkness cannot drive out darkness, only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate, only love can do that. Thank you all so much.
Thank you.
the large numbers that we have here to the courthouse to test Selma's good faith and the good faith of Dallas County on the whole question of the right to vote. And we are going to march with you. We want you to know that you have not only our moral support, but you have our physical support.
Good evening. My name is Dan Daniels. I am the second vice president for California and Hawaii State Conference of the NAACP. And I really want to thank your president, Ms. Satya Austin, for inviting me to say a few words. First thing I'd like to say is how much my wife and I love San Diego. Unfortunately, because of this pandemic, and I can't speak to you in person, I don't get to see the beautiful beach in San Diego, and I don't get to fellowship with my friends and other members of San Diego. As you know, we have been in trying times. For the last 4 years, racism has reared its ugly head. It has definitely shown a necessary need, an immediate need to have strong NAACP branches throughout the country, and we have continued to do that. North San Diego County, under the leadership of Ms. Satya Austin, has been one of the strongest branches in the state. You have always had a strong youth contingent, and I would like to thank Ms. Austin for being one of the best youth advisors in the state of California. The work of our youth, the number of AXO programs that we've been involved with, all has to do with your involvement, Ms. Austin, so for that, we salute you. As you know, this is Martin Luther King Day, and this is such an honor for me to speak about our community during this great time. Dr. King was such a brilliant man. He has been known for many of his speeches. I Have a Dream speech, the great iconic speech. But one speech that we seldom hear, I wanted to just talk to you about. I cannot deliver it as eloquently as Dr. King, but Dr. King gave this speech in 1967. And he says, I think there is an answer to that myth. And it is that time is neutral. It can be used either constructively or destructively.
And I'm absolutely convinced that the forces of ill will in our nation, the extreme rightists in our nation, have often used time much more effectively than the forces of goodwill. And it may well be that we will have to repent in this generation, not merely for the vitriolic words of the bad people and the violent actions of the bad people, but for the appalling silence and indifference of the good people who sit around and say, wait on time. Somewhere we must come to see that social progress never rolls in on the wheels of inevitability.
It comes through the tireless efforts and the persistent work and dedication of dedicated individuals. And without this hard work, time itself becomes an ally of the primitive force of social stagnation. And so we must help time. And we must realize that the time is always right to do right. That was said by Dr. King in 1967. And listening at that, I hope you can hear that he could be addressing the situation that we are in today. Who would have thought what has occurred in our country in the last 4 years? It's been 57 years since Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. delivered his iconic speech, I Have a Dream. It's been 6 months since Black Lives Matter murals were painted across the streets of America. And it's been 1 week since white supremacists stormed the Capitol in a failed attempt to overthrow our democracy. I say all this is to emphasize that we are far beyond the point of words and performative statements in this country. This is the year for deeper, more consecrated action. It has been too long since corporations, brand, public figures, and every people alike took a stand and publicly denounced racism and promised to control both internal and external injustices. Well, MLK Day is here. And there's never been a more apt time to fulfill those promises. As we recognize Dr. Martin Luther King's birthday and head into Black History Month, the NAACP is calling on those who commit to the movement to begin with individual brands and corporations should participate in MLK Day and Days of Service. We want you to sign equal pay pledges. Take a year-round approach to embracing the spirit of Martin Luther King Day. Publish a progress report. We want to go from June 2020 and stated action by June 2021. We want you to join the 1 million jobs campaign, and we hope that you can find support for diversity and inclusion leads within your organization, provide sustaining support to local social justice organization. The time is now. As you see, the NAACP is still strong, and we can continue to be strong with your help. We've got to get in our community. We respect the community of San Diego. It is such a beautiful place. And so I want you to give a pledge to get out, to make a difference, to try and make a difference in people's lives. Knowing that the NAACP was founded in 1909 by a group of Black and white citizens who were concerned with lynching, now is the time for us to come together. We've got a new president coming in office. The stimulus checks will be coming out. We need to mobilize together to make sure that everyone in our community has access to the coronavirus test as well as the coronavirus vaccine. You need to work with your health department and your local agencies, and we need you to encourage our community to get out, to get the vaccine. We have got to end this pandemic, and we can only do it if we all do it and work together. So I want to thank you for giving me this time, and I hope to see all of you at Dr. Hoffman's recognition for our Legacy Awards in February. And I want to see all of you at the table giving us a commitment to work and to serve in your community to make our communities a better place for all. Thank you very much.
In honor of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., I march for racial equity and for the youth in our community. Dr. King once told us that nothing shall be more redemptive in freeing our children from the permanent and psychological death that stems from racism and oppression. Dr. King urged us to not engage in the luxury of cooling off or to take the tranquilizing drug of gradualism. Dr. King urged us to march. So today, in honor of Dr. King, I march with intent and I march with purpose to bring hope to our community and to bring hope to our youth.
For police reform.
For justice.
Because I am more than just the color of my skin.
For those who can't.
Equity.
Tolerance.
For economic equality.
Because our lives depend on.
Greetings, everyone. My name is Inez Williams, and I am the chairperson for the City of Oceanside Housing Commission and the chairperson for the City of Oceanside Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Community Service Award. Annually, the Oceanside City Council honors a resident of Oceanside or Marine Corps Base Camp Pendleton with the Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Community Service Award. This award is given to someone who exemplifies the philosophy and ideals of the late Dr. King, who worked to advance civil rights, equal education, labor rights, voter rights, and who fought racial inequality through nonviolence and civil disobedience. This year, we had 5 nominees for this award. Our first nominee is Mr. Eddie Bickham. Eddie has been an active volunteer in the Oceanside community for over 20 years. After retiring from the United States Marine Corps at the rank of Lieutenant Colonel, Eddie continues to exhibit his love for the community through supporting the Senior Meals Delivery Program, Gentleman's Shelf for the North County African American Women's Association, support of Shiloh Church of God in Christ annual holiday food drives, and Toys for Tots programs. NAACP Dr. King Day of Service, youth mentor with a youth program for Xi Gamma Gamma Chapter of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated. Eddie Bickham takes great pride helping the City of Oceanside and its residents in support and outreach programs to improve the lives of Oceanside citizens and community. Our next nominee is Ms. Marva Bledsoe. Marva has given over 40 years of service to the City of Oceanside by empowering the lives of survivors of sexual assault and domestic violence through her work at the Women's Resource Center. Marva has also been a member of the Oceanside Chamber of Commerce since 1978 and has served as board chair on 2 occasions. Marva is an excellent example and role model for the younger generation as she works to implement the ideas of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Our next nominee is Dr. Adrian Hakes. She has served the Oceanside community for over 40 years. Dr. Hakes is on the library board as a member in her 20th year of service. She has been an active member of the American Association of University Women for over 20 years. Her involvement in different organizations has enabled her to have an understanding of our community and how these valuable organizations could have an impact in enriching the lives of many. Our next nominee is Vanessa Graziana. Since early 2020, Vanessa has been providing food, shelter, and care to homeless individuals around Oceanside. She started Oceanside Homeless Resource after her own experience with homelessness several years back. Vanessa and Oceanside Homeless Resource is centered on the principles of building a community for those in need. And our last nominee is Oscarian Ortega. Oscarian founded Lived Experiences to provide support for underserved youth in Oceanside, particularly those in the Crown Heights neighborhood. Oscarian, having experienced his own trauma, has devoted his life to mentoring and training youth. Oscarian and Lived Experience are providing essential services to Oceanside youth. Let's congratulate all of our nominees. At this time, I would like to invite the mayor of Oceanside, Mayor Esther Sanchez, to come forward and announce the winner of this year's City of Oceanside Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Community Service Award. Mayor Sanchez?
Thank you, Inez. Hi, I am Mayor Esther Sanchez, proudly representing the City of Oceanside. It gives me great pleasure to announce the winner of this year's 32nd Annual Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Community Service Award. The Dr. King Community Service Award has become a proud tradition in Oceanside, honoring those individuals who unselfishly and tirelessly contribute of their time, making a real difference in the lives of people in our communities, promoting positive change, civic duty, and activism, reflective of the life of Dr. King. As you heard, this year we had so many wonderful finalists, each giving so much of themselves. I would like to thank each of the finalists for their wonderful contributions in making Oceanside and the North San Diego County a better place, especially for our at-risk youth, seniors, and families. And now, the winner. Please join me in congratulating this year's 32nd Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Community Service Award recipient. I present to you our winner, retired Lieutenant Colonel Eddie Bickham. Congratulations, Eddie.
Thank you, Mayor Sanchez, for your kind introduction. I also wish to thank the members of the selection committee for your diligence and hard work. Receiving the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Community Service Award is indeed an honor that I never expected. I'm humbled by this selection, and I will cherish it for the rest of my life. Oceanside has been my home since first being stationed at Camp Pendleton in January 1977. Since that time, my wife has been an educator in the Oceanside Unified School District, and three of our sons have graduated from El Camino High School. Upon retiring from the Marine Corps in 2000, I have officially called Oceanside home and have done my best to support the city and my community as best I could. Dr. King's ideals and teachings have affected each of us in our own way. His fight for racial equality and justice for all through peaceful, nonviolent civil demonstrations are lessons that we must all remember now more than ever. I beseech each of you listening to remember those teachings and to do honor to Dr. King by trying to live his creed in your daily lives. In our America today, especially in this time of political unease and a nationwide pandemic, we will only overcome our disharmony by caring for each other, supporting each other, and having faith in God and each other. Thank you again for selecting me for this prestigious award, and I pray that God will keep you and your families safe.
As we come to the close of our program, we would like to acknowledge our community partners, sponsors, friends, and our members that have made today possible. This year's theme, the endemic culture of racism and privilege, is a reminder of what we are fighting for and why we must use our voice and continue marching. Despite the many challenges we have had this year, organizations like the NAACP have carried on the work of Dr. King to keep his dream alive for future generations. Thank you. Enjoy the rest of your day.
I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
colorful future. Skin don't define any human, and stars are the only thing shooting, shooting. Whoa. Mothers who bury their child, how can we sit there and hide? Change comes when all take a stand and stand up, stand up.
Thank you.